Welcome back, everyone. Today, we're learning about a vector design tool that's very important, but tricky to master. But by the end of this video, I think you'll find that it's easier than it seems. Now, I've already picked up the pen tool from the toolbar, so first, I'm going to show you how to draw a few simple shapes. If I click once on the canvas, I create a single node. If I click again, a line appears in between my two points. This is called a path segment. And if I just continue clicking on my canvas, I end up with this zigzag. To finish my path, all I need to do is double click on the last node. Or I can go to the Nodes tab in the inspector and press this check mark here. With this process, it's easy to create any polygon that you need. Just click once to create each corner, and then click one last time on the first node to close the shape. If you want to create perfect shapes, like a square, well, we have the shape tool for that. But you can also draw a square with the pen tool by making use of our grid and activating the snap to grid function. Okay, now let's move on to what the pen tool is best known for, curves. Making a curve is easy. Instead of just clicking once, I click and drag my mouse at the same time. Now, I've created a node, but it has two handles attached to it. As long as I don't release the mouse button, I can keep adjusting the length and rotation of these two handles, which will ultimately decide the shape of the curve. Let's stop here. Then, I click and drag one more time, and this is the path we end up with. But let's move on to another artboard, where I've prepared some guidelines. These will indicate where I need to click, in which direction I need to drag, and how much. From these guidelines, you can see which actions create which type of curve. So let's click, drag down, click, drag up, and then click again on our last node to end our path. Now we're left with a perfect dome. But if I drag in the same direction, we get a wave. And this is what happens when I drag diagonally. You can click and drag in any direction to create unlimited shapes. But now let's move on to a practical example. Here's what it looks like. It's always easier to start with a sketch, so here all I'm going to do is follow its outline. So let me click and drag the pen tool along my sketch. Notice that I'm adjusting each path as I go, by moving the node handles until the curve matches the sketch underneath. And that's it. But what if I want to trace this kind of shape? The process is pretty much the same, but I'm having a bit of an issue here matching this corner, where my shape takes a sharp turn. In this case, I need to change my node type from the default, which is asymmetric, highlighted here, to disconnected, which is this one. The easiest way to do this is to use the pen tool as you normally would. And then once you encounter a sharp angle, just press the Option key and continue your path. Looking good. You can also do the same thing by clicking again on the node. We'll explain more about the node tool in a later video, but for now, practice using these techniques to master Vectornator's pen tool. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button and like this video if it was helpful for you, and let us know what other tutorials you want to see from us in the future. See you next time!